may have 1,000 active styles, maybe 200 of them in production at any one point in time. But you know, everybody wants a different slub pattern, a different cast of the indigo, you know, different weaves, different this, different that, different weights. So, you know, to service our customers, we've got to make a huge amount of styles versus in the old days, not much so. I mean, this book right here, which I think, does it have a date in the front? I can't remember. This probably represents where we might have 1,000 active styles. This probably represented everything they had at that point in time, which might be, what, 25 here? Mm-hmm. And they probably weren't making more than 5-10 at the most at any one point in time, because that's just the way the market was back then. The fabric that went into the Levi 501 jean, the shrink to fit jean, didn't change for generations, either in shade or construction or anything. It stayed the same.
And so everything you guys pretty much made, you know, in the early days was salvage.
Yeah, oh yeah. When I said that there were 2,000 looms here, every one of them was a fly shuttle loom.
So basically 1905 is when you guys opened this factory.
This factory, yes.
And then from 1905 till about
70s. Would that be right, Staley? In the 70s is when the salvage loom started coming out of here. And it didn't happen completely at once. It happened in waves. But by the mid 80s, they were all long gone. Yeah.
And then they came back 10 years later.
Yeah. Yeah. So.
It's so good that you guys didn't throw it out.
We're glad we didn't need it. Yeah. Yeah, we can't make enough on these fly shuttles right now.
That's
really but you know, when you look back in history, that has changed.
Sure.
You know, when we put them back in here, we did it primarily for the LVC division at Levi's. And, you know, they'd give us some fabrics to make, and within 6 months, they had enough inventory for 2 or 3 years, and we turned the looms off. It just became hard to run them because we didn't have enough business. Well, then, of course, we opened it up to other customers, and then as time has gone on, it's gotten more and more popular. Now we wish we had a few more. But there are still, you were asking, are there other looms? There are still some out on the market. Other mills, not necessarily denim mills, but that was just a standard fly shuttle loom that was used for many years in the textile industry as a whole. So there are plenty of those still out there. Of course, they have to be refurbished, and you can't get parts for them anymore. You basically have to find somebody who can make parts for them, because the draper is out of business.
Sure.
So, there's no draper parts. A salesperson would have had this book to take on sales calls. And see, it gives you the width, 28-29, coming off a narrow loom. It gives you the weight, sanforized. Of course, any fabric that did not go into the shrink to fit would have been a sanforized or pre-shrunk fabric.
Which was invented in the 30s.
It was invented in the 30s, yeah. And they did do some novelty fabrics. When you get back here, some other colors. There's some sulfur colors where you can get, now this would be a non-indigo. You can get this burgundy shade. You can get these olive shades,
yeah,
like this. You can also get sulfur navies and sulfur browns. This would have been a sulfur here as well, even though that's a light blue. Could have done that with indigo. And there were a couple of novelty weaves in here, which were very, very rare back in the old days. Most everything they would have made would either been you see, that's a novelty weave right there. Now, they would probably have this in the line for somebody who was looking for something different. But a fabric like this would not have been a big seller, because it's outside the norm. And see, it's not even an indigo. And then a real heavy twill line like that, that's not a heavyweight fabric, but look at the distinction of the twill line.
Sure.
That's And then you've got plenty of 2x1s, which the 2x1 twills ended up in the lighter weight that made up the bib overalls, and then the heavier denims going up to all the way up to 14.5 ounces made the jeans.
Right.
Or as they called them in the old days, short-waisted overalls, as you know. And then they would have done some novelty work like this. These are very difficult today because you have to basically lay these patterns in by hand.
Yeah.
And but, you know, it had a home with the railroad.
Sure.
I don't know beyond that. You see a lot of old jackets made of this railroad stripe.
Hats, too.
Hats. Occasionally some old jeans will come up in there. I consider us to be the real deal, and we're not going to stop being the real deal. As long as there is interest, as long as there's a market for shuttle fabrics, we will continue to make shuttle fabrics and continue to work with our customers to design both aesthetically and technically what it is they want.